Dear children,
my daughter work cook ma'am.
Today we will be discussing creative writing
ma'am
from our workbook. Who is speaking now?
Ma'am, the AP number.
Ma'am, excuse me ma'am.
Who is speaking?
Sahil.
Okay, Sahil. I know that you don't have the textbook. You take a piece of paper or a notebook. Okay.
And which page?
Page number 28. Page number 28.
Ma'am, can you send this workbook in WhatsApp?
Yes, Sahil. Now you listen, okay? You listen carefully. Page number 28. Creative writing. Today we are going to deal with the topic diary entry. Okay, diary writing or diary entry.
Okay,
close your books, all of you. Now close your books. I don't want you to keep it open. Close your books, all of you. Let me ask you, how many of you have the habit of writing a diary?
Yes.
Payal? Nainika, then who else? Ethan, do you write diary?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay, Nainika and Payal. Hazib, what about you? I don't think many of you have the habit of writing a diary entry. Do you know what is a diary entry? Nainika, can you tell me?
Yes, ma'am, I know.
Yes, Nainika, what do you mean by diary writing? Nainika, unmute and speak fast. What do you mean by diary writing? Okay, she's not sure of, or maybe due to network problem. Where is Payal?
Yes, ma'am, here.
Yes, Payal, tell me.
Like what happened on the day, like after coming from home, what happened when we went outside, I write it down in my diary.
Do you still write diary?
Yeah, I still continue writing. I finished one diary and I'm continuing the second one.
Wow, that's great. Okay, so I do understand that Payal constantly writes a diary. Okay, so children, what do you mean by diary? Have you seen a diary?
No, I have one.
A diary is just a book. Okay, diary. Yes, diary is just a book. You may get every year from the school. You may get a school diary. Have you seen school diary?
Yes.
There will be an index page where you can give all the informations about yourself. Then it may consist of prayers, then pledge, national anthem, and few pages in the middle. And towards the end, you may find a form for applying leave and so on, isn't it? So yes. That is what you call a school diary. But there is personal diary also, then official
and
diaries.
I have.
So, yeah. Yes, Delna has got one diary. I think it belongs to her father. Huh?
I mean, it is mine. I'm using.
Did you get it from your father, Delna?
Yeah, ma'am. My one uncle gave.
Okay. Uncle gifted her, I suppose, because it is written Police 2019.
Yes.
It's a police diary. Okay. Yeah. So that as a gift she received from her uncle. So various kinds of diaries are there, okay? Personal diaries, official diaries, school diary, and so on. So today we are going to discuss about personal diaries. Okay, personal diaries. So personal, what do you understand by personal? Personal from the very... Yes. Personal diary entry. Personal. So from the very word itself, you can derive another word. Which word can you get from this word personal?
Person.
Very good. Alvina, very good answer. Person. Okay. From the word personal, we can derive a word person. So today, we are going to discuss about personal diary entries. Personal diary entry or personal diary writing. So what do you mean by personal diary writing? Tell me. What do you mean by personal diary writing? Personal diary writing means that diary writing includes ourselves. Some matters, some events, some situations that relates to our own life.
What happens in our life that yes. you're writing?
Yes. Whatever that happens in our life, we write it in our personal diaries. We also express our emotions, our feelings, our expectations, our hopes, our wishes, everything into this diary, and then it becomes personal. Did you understand?
Yes.
All yes. right. So there are certain rules. There are certain rules that we have to keep in our mind when we write a personal diary. Okay. So let's see what are those. So we are going to learn about personal diary writing. And there are a few rules that we have to keep in our mind when we learn how to write a diary entry. Is it clear, Angelo?
Yes.
Yes. All right. So children, look at the screen. One by one, I'm going to explain what are the rules that you have to follow when you write a diary entry. The first one, you have to mention the day and date. Okay, day and date. So this part cannot be omitted. Day and date. That part cannot be omitted. It is very, very important. Whenever you write a diary entry, you have to write day and date on top of your page on the very left hand side. Is that clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, all right. Then the second point. The second point is you can address your diary. You can address your diary. For example, when you write a letter, imagine that Noel and Nia. Where are you right now, Noel and Nia? Are you in Italy?
Italy. Yes. Yes.
Still in Italy, right? Okay, okay.
Yes.
Okay. So from Italy, just imagine that you are writing a letter to me. Okay, just imagine that you are writing a letter to me. So how will you begin your letter?
Dear ma'am.
Ah, yes, dear ma'am. Dear ma'am, isn't it?
Yes.
Ah, okay, okay, so many things are there to be included. But before you writing, before you start a paragraph, you will address the letter as dear ma'am or dear Anupama ma'am. Isn't it? Yes. So that is what you call as salutation or greeting. Okay. When you write a letter, if you are writing a letter to your mom, you may write dear mama, dear mummy, dear amma, whatever you call. Or if you are writing a letter to your father, dear dad, dear papa, dear appa, and so on. Okay. So just like when you write a letter, you address the person to whom you are writing. Similarly, you also address your diary. So you can start your diary by just referring as dear diary. Okay, dear diary. Or just imagine that you have given a name for your diary. Suppose diary is a pet for you. So you can call Kitty. Suppose if you are given the name to your diary as Kitty, you can call dear Kitty. My dear loving Kitty. Or some other cute name, cutie pie, or some cute names you can give for your diary, and you can address your diary as dear cutie pie, dear kitty, or dear diary. Is that clear? That is the second point. If it is clear, give me a thumbs up, all of you. Yes. Okay, very good. Then the third point that we have to keep in mind is write in the first person. Write in the first person. What do you mean by first person? In grammar, you're studying about first person, second person, third person.
I is first person.
Yes. Use I. Use I. I is the first person. He, she, or it all comes as second person. We, they all comes as third person. So as I told you, yes. Yes, Alvina.
My also.
Yes, yes. My also. That's also first person. I, my, mine all comes as first person. Okay. Good. Good, Elvina. So, whenever you write a diary entry, remember, it's your personal work. Okay. That is your personal. It is a privacy. It is a matter of privacy. All your secrets are written in the diary entry, isn't it? Yes. And you will not show it to anybody else.
Yes.
You will keep it as secret. Yes, Haseeb?
Someone will find it.
Somebody will find it. Maybe your father and mother may find it and read it. But other than your parents, nobody is allowed to read because it's your personal thing. Okay. Unless and until you permit somebody to read, nobody is allowed to read it because it's your personal matter. It's your privacy. It's your secrets. Okay. So of course, do not hide secret. Do not keep your things away from your parents. Okay. Your parents should know everything about you.
I yet didn't show to my parents.
Yes. Of course, your parents should know what you're writing, what you're dealing with. You should not hide anything from your parents. But you can keep it safe from your friends or your relatives or your siblings and all. Okay. So you have to use I always because you're writing about your feelings, your emotions, your expectations, your wishes and so on. Then the fourth rule, write in the past tense. Do you know what is past tense, present tense and future tense?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes.
So always use the past tense, preferably simple past tense. Okay. So present tense means something that is going on right now. Okay. The teacher is teaching the children. It is present tense, present continuous tense, isn't it? Future tense means something is that going to come in the future. I will be teaching you a story in the next class. Okay, that is future tense. But what is past tense? Something that has already
happened.
Happened. Yes, something that has already happened. So you can write, you can always write your diary entry in the simple past tense form. Is that clear, children? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, good. Smart ones. So write it in the past tense. Then the fifth rule, use informal language. Informal language.
It's not a respected.
Informal language or conversational style. Conversational style. So as I told you, suppose if you're writing a leave letter to me, just imagine that I am your class teacher. Okay, just imagine that I am your class teacher. Are you all listening? Are you all with me? Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very good, very good. Just imagine that I am your class teacher. One day, you took a leave. You were not able to come to the class one day because you went to attend your cousin's marriage. You went to attend your cousin's marriage and you took a leave. The next day, you are bringing a leave application to me. Sahal, what are you doing there? Sahal, you are bringing a leave application to me. So can you tell me how will you address? How will you address the class teacher?
Dear ma'am.
Okay, some of you say that, dear ma'am. Okay, Haseeb.
Dear ma'am, please.
I just want the beginning. Okay. Some of you said, dear ma'am. Okay. Listen. Some of you told me you would address me as dear ma'am. Payal said that, respected ma'am. So what is the difference between dear ma'am and respected ma'am?
Dear is informal and respected is formal.
Very good. Perfect answer, Payal. Dear is an informal way of expression. Dear ma'am, that means you show that you have a close relationship with your teacher. The teacher understands you very well. She interacts with you very well. You have a close relationship. That is why you are referring to the teacher as dear ma'am. Okay, informal way of expression. But when it comes to respected ma'am, it is a formal way of expression. Respected ma'am means it's a formal way of expression. Do you get me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so whenever you write a diary entry, it should be in the informal way. That means you should not write in the diary, respected diary. Do you like write like that? No. You will not write? No. Respect a diary. No, diary is just like a friend. Suppose if you are writing a letter to your friend, will you just address them as respected friend or respected Payal Ramesh?
No.
Will you say so? Respected Mevil Lijo?
No.
Respected Ridhu K. Anoop? Will you write a letter like that?
No.
No. You may write like this. Dear Ridhu, my dearest Payal, my dear loving Mevil. Like that you would address. So, informal and formal. Formal means respected. You always write respected sir, respected madam. Informal means dear Noel, dear Nia. Okay, like that. Understood? So, whenever you write a diary entry, you have to use informal language or conversational style. Is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
To all of you? The next point, sixth point is end with a wish. End with a wish.
Yeah, ma'am, I wish to be.
Yes. Hope or decision or conclusion. Decision or conclusion. End with a wish, hope, decision, or conclusion. That means, for example, just imagine that your English exams are got over. Okay? Your English exams are over. Yes, of course, periodic test exams, all the exams are over, not only English. Okay. So, on the day of your English exam, you attempted the exams, but somehow you missed out two questions. Imagine that you missed out two questions. Okay, only after submitting the answers, you came to know that you missed out two questions. You became so sad because you really know the answers of those questions very well. But somehow, unfortunately, you missed it out. Aiden, are you listening? Yes. Okay, good. So somehow you missed out those two questions and you became very upset. On that day, at night, you are writing the diary entry. Okay, so in the diary, you are writing, today my English exams got over and it was quite easy for me, but unfortunately I missed out two questions and I know that I will not be able to score 20 out of 20. But next day, tomorrow I have my social exams. Okay, but I'm sure I will be very careful not to omit. Social science exam, Sahil. Okay, so you are wishing tomorrow I have got my social science exam and I will be very careful not to omit any of the answers. Okay, so that is what you mean by wishing. You're hoping that you will score full marks. So all those feelings you're writing down in your diary entry. Is that clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, and one more point, that the last rule that we are learning, that is sign off with your name. Sign off with your name by ending. Sign off with your name when you end the diary entry. Okay, after writing the paragraph, you have to mention your name or whoever is writing the diary entry. So we'll go through these points once again, children. Okay, and one more thing, these writing sections can come for 5 marks for written exam. Okay, 5 marks. It can ask for 5 marks, so you have to study it thoroughly. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So let's go through the rules once again. First rule, mention day and date. Okay, on the top side, left hand side, on the top of the sheet, you have to write the day and date. Then start with dear diary. Write it in the first person. Always use I. Then write in the past tense. Use informal or conversational style of language. Then end with the wish, hope, decision, or conclusion. And sign off with your name. Is it clear? Are these rules clear to you, children?
Yeah.
Yes.
Now you can open your textbook. All of you open your workbook. All of you open your workbook.
Page number 28.
A sample diary entry is given there. A sample diary entry.
A diary.
Okay, Ridhu, you haven't muted. Would you like to read, Ridhu? Yes? Okay, read the diary entry that is given. Friday, 3 August. Did you see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so from the beginning, diary entry, from the beginning you can read.
A diary is a book in which one can write about things that happen in their life. Life on a daily...
In their lives on a daily basis.
One shares their thoughts, feelings, hopes and dreams in their diaries. Look at the
sample. Look at the sample. Sample means example. Look at the sample of a diary entry below.
I'm in workbook.
Yes, it's in the workbook. Okay, diary. Next. Okay, Ridhu, can I give chance to somebody else?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Len. Len, are you there? Yes, read it loudly.
Friday, 3rd August. Dear diary, my half yearly exam are going.
Exams on. Are going on.
I had my English exam today.
I had my English exam today.
Even though I studied quite hard for the exam, it did not go as well as I had hoped.
As I had hoped. There is a full stop. So you have to pause. Then.
I ran out of time and could not finish the last two answers.
Okay. Thank you, Len. Next, I want Akshay to read. Akshay, read.
Ma'am, what?
Do you have the workbook with you, Akshay?
No.
Oh, that's why. Do you know what we are discussing now? Did you concentrate? Did you listen?
Yes.
Okay, my boy. Anay, read.
What hurts even more is that those were writing
exercises
and I usually do well in those. Anyway, I have my science exam on Monday and I have promised myself that I'll write it quickly from the beginning. Adil.
Yes, okay, very good. So now we saw a diary entry which is written by a boy named Adil. Okay. And he has written about his own personal feelings, how he attempted the exam and he missed out some because he could not write the answers for the writing section in English exam. Okay. And he feels very sad about it, but he is promising to himself that he will prepare quite well for the science exam. Okay. Now take page number 29. All of you take page number 29. Page number 29. Another diary entry is given there on page number 29. But in that diary entry, you can find some parts which are incorrect.
Yes, that
means which are not correct. Yes, yes. Wait. Some parts given in the diary entry is written in the incorrect way. So we have to find out which are those incorrected parts. You have to circle the incorrect parts in your textbook. Okay, I'll give you 2 minutes time. Do it quickly.
Ma'am, I do not have workbook.
Ma'am, page number
29. Those who do not have the workbook, I'll do one thing. I'll send the pages to you through WhatsApp. Okay, then you can
workbook, but I forgot to take.
Children, quickly find out what are the mistakes in that diary entry. Hey Garaj. Hey Garaj, what are you doing there?
My brother is disturbing.
Abiram is there? Your brother?
Yes.
Tell him to move away. Abiram, don't sit near to your brother. Don't disturb him. Hey Garaj. Take out your workbook and do what I said.
On page number 29.
Yes. Go through the diary entry in detail and find out what is a mistake. Finished? Have you finished? Finished. Okay, Nainika finished. Tonya finished.
Ma'am, let's finish.
Okay, Len also finished. Noel and Nia, very good. Finished. Payal. Okay. Binu, finished? No? Okay, do it. Many of the cameras are off, so I'm going to mark you all absent here. Why should I give you attendance if your videos are off? I can see you all on the screen. If you're not visible, I'll quickly mark it absent, that's all. And when it is time for exam, you will have to meet the chairman for explaining the reason why your videos are off. Okay. All right. So children, let's discuss one by one. Leonardo, tell me, what is the mistake that you find in the diary entry given in the textbook? Any mistake that you have noticed?
Respected.
Yes, very good. Respected. What is a mistake? Why do you think that it is a mistake? It is written respected diary. Why do you think it is a mistake, Leonardo? You have to give me the reason also. Okay, I'll ask Tonio. Tonio, what he said is correct or not?
Yes, ma'am, correct.
Yes, okay, agreed. Why do you think it's a mistake, respected diary? Why do you think it's a mistake?
He know the diary.
Why?
And we want to say
yes, we have to address the diary as
dear diary, not respected.
Yes, dear diary. This is wrong. Okay. Dear diary. It is an informal way. Informal way of addressing the diary. So we have to write dear diary.
Ma'am, can Alvina say the next?
Ma'am, can I? You want to?
Ma'am, can I?
Wait. Niranjan.
Ma'am.
Yes, Egaraj.
Ma'am, can I leave?
Yes.
Who has class?
Okay. Who will give me the answer? Yes, Angelo, give me the answer. Others, be quiet.
There is only September.
Yes, it's very good. Very good, Angelo. It is written only September. So, what is to be written? September.
Date.
This part is wrong, but instead we have to write
8th and 8th.
Either it is to be written 10th September.
27th September.
2021. Okay. Or we have to write 10th September Monday.
September.
Okay. Like this we have to Sunday. Write. Yes, Sunday or Monday or whichever day. It is.
Yes. Ma'am, I told my point.
Which is the next point? Which is the next error that you find? One more. Yes. We will wind up quickly, but one more. Yes. Yes. Very good. Correct. Riya. The name is mentioned there.
We want to write the I.
Yes, exactly. Very good. Riya, that is wrong. But instead, you have to write I. Because Riya herself is writing the letter. So it should be like, I played with my friends in the evening. And we, one more mistake is there. Instead of have is wrong.
Yes.
Have is wrong. It is written the present form. But you have to write had.
I don't.
We had a lot of fun. Okay. We had a lot of fun.
I like three.
Okay. So in total, there are four mistakes. Yes. How many of you got four out of four? Four. Did you find out four mistakes? Okay. All right. Okay. Nainika was able.
I do not have workbook.
All right. So children, I'll be giving you a homework today. Okay. Just try and write a diary entry for the next class. And also those who got the seminar topics, please be prepared. Okay. So thank you, children. I'll meet you in the next session. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am.